Hello, everybody on the interwebs. My name is Marie, and you are joining us today for React and Discuss with Konnect'd. The two weirdos under me, the one in the middle is Sam, and the one at the bottom is Tandy. They're going to be our other reactors today. So, Konnect'd React and Discuss is where we react and discuss and talk about some of the newest music videos that just came out, maybe some old ones. But today specifically is going to be a new one, and I'm really excited for it. They call me a big hit stan. You know, I mean, I do support Big Hit. Doesn't matter what group it is. But today is going to be TXT, Can You See Me? Now, I'm excited for this one. I have heard a lot of good things about it. Y'all, you know what? I'm tired of the ones underneath me, but have y'all heard any good things about this?
I've heard that the interwebs are a buzz.
Yes.
A buzz.
Yes.
A buzz.
I saw the teaser and it was like this. And so I'm ready to watch it.
Like this.
Like,
okay. Mm-hmm. Well, let's get into this. I'm ready. 1, 2, 3, hit it. Oh, that classic Big Hit. I still think of BTS whenever I hear this. It was there for so long.
That is
true. I'm just used to it.
I was about to say nothing's changing, but it's the top. It was the top at the first.
Oh.
You know what?
Oh, I like this voice.
I like his hair.
They've matured so much.
Calling the firefighters, like
they're letting them
just gonna let this. Who I hope whoever's house that was, their parents has insurance, because my mother would be livid.
Okay. So first thoughts before we get into actually watching it again.
Marie.
Oh, I was talking to you guys saying like first thoughts.
Yeah, I need to hear you first.
This was interesting. They have matured so much from Cat Dog and all of their original songs. So I love this growth. I love the vocal range that was in this. When I'm watching this, I'm feeling like it's a friendship that's slowly breaking down. Like they're trying to go back to how they were in their youth when they were friends and everything was the same, but they keep saying, you know, my friends don't understand me anymore. Like, can you see who the person I'm trying to be? But as they're trying to be that person, it's like they're fighting a war and it's just all the negative things. So even when they're together, they feel like when they keep showing themselves like solo by themselves, even when they're together, they're not themselves. And when they are themselves, it's like destruction. Like everything's just kind of breaking down around them. I don't know. It's interesting. It's definitely very juxtaposition, because like, I think it's Kai that's sitting there against the wall and everybody's going around him, past him, but he's like by himself. So even it was that even in the crowded room, I still feel alone. And that's kind of how they each looked, where maybe they used to be each other's happiness. And then even when they're together and you see everybody looking like they're having fun, each person still feels alone. So
yeah.
Interesting.
Who was the one sitting on the stairs outside the house by himself a couple of times? Like towards the end.
I will have to go back to it because I don't remember, because all of them were sitting at one point. They had two of them sitting at the end of the stairs, but two different frames. So when we go and actually look into the discussion portion, then I'll tell you who was who.
Okay.
What did you guys think?
I know I need another viewing because this is a lot. But it's like really busy and there's a lot going on. I'm like, oh, processing. Can't process fast enough. That's me.
Understandable. Which is why we have our discussion portion and we are going to take a quick break. We are going to go review this music video a few more times and then get back to you. So we are back. All right. We are back. We have watched it, analyzed. I'm going to try not to go too deep because I might got a lot to say and I don't need to have a lot to say for this. And I might do a theory video after because, you know, Big Hit Universe, we love theories in this house. So y'all want me to go first, you said, because y'all think I don't want to skew any of your ideas. I might be completely wrong. Now, I am a TXT fan. I am not a stan. Therefore, I might get confused with their names and stuff because I don't follow them as tightly as I follow my other groups. But I still do love my baby boys. So if we go based off of just the content of what's happening here. If this is a video for somebody who's never heard of TXT, Sam will do more of a thought process towards that. But for me, I think it can be a little confusing because you don't know everything that's kind of going on. There's a lot going on at once. So it can come off as very confusing, and that's completely understandable. But let me just go over production-wise. I think it was great. This is a very well thought out. You could tell that there's a storyline with this. Now the storyline goes through a lot. Like, it's shot beautifully. The sets are well done. I honestly love the food fight scene. They look like they're having so much fun in it. And even they're like, you see these close-ups of them and these pullouts. This is just a production-wise, it's Big Hit. They have money. They put their all into this and you can see it. And audio quality, sound mixing, all of that sounded great. Their voices were completely clear. Taehyun's voice, angelic. I love his voice. Honestly, vocals, ethereal. This is a song. I think I like the song more than the music video. Or I can listen to the song more than I can watch the music video over and over again. But the music video is fun. But the reason I can't watch it over and over again is because I start getting new theories. So I must do a little theory. Just a little theory. So this goes back to Runaway. And in Runaway, and it must also connect with what I said earlier. I still stick with what I was saying, but on a little different form. So Runaway, which is the music video before this, you'll see them going into a different dimension. And you see fire a lot in that music video. And then you see this pattern showing up, which it looks like they are trying different spells. And they go into the Magic Island, which gets mentioned in this video. And they are there together. And when they're going there, you literally see this thing in the middle that lights up to complete fire. Like, and them just standing around the fire. And then it obviously, as you see now, translates to this home. So this feels like, to me, their friendship. If you're going theories wise, it's they got lost in that dimension and they didn't survive in that dimension. And so when they came back, this is actually not them, but their ghost. And so, like I said, there's a lot. That's one version of a theory. A second version of this theory is that this represents a toxic relationship and a toxic friendship, and that them throwing these strawberries and tomatoes at each other is the representation of hate, and they're basically slinging insults and other hate and other issues at each other as a physical representation through this. So it started off as something fun and joking, which, you know how it goes with friends. Sometimes you guys will be fun, joking, and playing around, and then it goes too far. And it's like all of their insecurities, all of their issues with each other are literally represented in that scene. And they are at Subin's house, and you'll notice that he's the only one that stays. And he basically tells everybody to leave. Like, he is no longer having fun. He is done with this. It also transpicts that at the beginning, too, is the friendship. Like, right now, you'll see everybody standing outside besides Subin, because he's still inside, because he's like, I'm not dealing with this anymore. That representation also starts at the beginning, where you see they might be having fun, like I had said at the beginning, but little things were starting to nitpick. Like, and he was just kind of over it. Like, was it Kai or Taeyeon? One of them pressed his gum, and he was over it. They're playing, and he's sitting alone against the wall. So I said Kai earlier, but it was Subin sitting alone against the wall. And he's just like, it's like he's there, but he's not. And this beginning part is showing parts of the Run music video, Runaway music video. So it's catching on fire. So it's literally those two realities are going to be coming together. And either whatever happened in that first reality of them going into this magical island, and Bomgyu, he is kind of like the catalyst. I feel like he is the cat in this instance, or I say, he's possessed by the cat in this instance, and he likes this, so he is trying to push it more. So it's like all the stuff that's happening, when it goes red, it's you see his face, and then everything bad starts happening from there. Anything that bad happens, you see kind of him in the middle. He's also the one holding the blanket over somebody. And it's like he's either trying to extinguish the fire, or he's trying to stop what's happening. So let me stop talking. There's a lot of theories that go with this, but overall, music video, after looking into a little bit more, I love it. Like, I love everything about the concept. I love videos that keep me thinking and keep me guessing. And like I said, big hit, y'all, you know, y'all like to create theories and universes and mess up people's head that will keep you up for hours, because I still go back to BTS's stuff, and I know I'm going to still go back to TXT's stuff and try to reanalyze this again. But I really enjoyed it. So that was a lot.
It was. I agree.
It was deep.
Very deep. I don't know. From a person on the outside that doesn't know the stories or understand the theories per se, I liked it. I like when a company or a group says, okay, this is what we're going to do, maybe to draw people in. But I also feel like that can push them away, in the sense that, like, this is a lie. I don't know if I feel like thinking. I just want to watch video. However, it sounds good. Like, it's very melodic and catchy, and I do like that about it. I agree with the definitely listening to the song more than watching the video again. I feel like watching the video is if you're ready to, like, kind of indulge into maybe who the group is and what the storyline is, if you're a storyline person. I love storylines. I like concepts that kind of, they don't have to make sense, to be honest. I like thinking, like Marie said as well. However, I don't want to be too thrown off that I'm just like, I don't know if I want to figure this out, you know? So I don't know. It could go both ways for certain people. Some people might be like, oh, I do want to know more. Some people might be like, this is a lot, you know? But I think they will keep some people interested by having, okay, there's a food fight in it. Who doesn't like to watch a food fight? I don't, because it makes me annoyed. And I'm like, who gonna clean that up? I do the same thing with, like, explosions in movies. Like, when, like, cities fall apart, I'm like, who gonna fix that, you know? So that's food fights bother me, because I'm just like, yo, somebody gonna have to clean that up. The house burning, what I do realize is that there's a lot of symbols, and I'm glad that Marie did go in on some of the topics. Hopefully this will get a lot of people conversing in our comments, you know, because
yes,
I like to hear people talk about it. I will get informed if I'm somebody on the outside that doesn't know about the stuff, and I do want to hear about the stuff. Do I want to know about the stuff? Maybe, if you can make it interesting enough for me. But no. A couple things I did want to mention was with the lyrics, especially, was I saw Save Me. There was stuff like My Heart's Incinerated. left alone, turn your back when the fire is burning. I was like, oh, they getting this mm-hmm. This is definitely storyline stuff that I know I would have to go back on. I really found this interesting, the beginning part of the book burning interesting. I'm glad that you said that it's from another video. So that would make me want to go back and watch the other video just because you said it's from another video. Now, if I didn't know this, then I'd be like, why he burning the book? And why is there like things happening simultaneously? And like the book is burning in the picture, but then it actually starts to burn, which is cool. But also, like I said, some people might get thrown off by it. But I do like the visuals. The visuals is enough. Visuals is enough to keep people possibly like interested in watching the video. But like I said, it's hit or miss as far as who would want to get into the storyline. I do see a lot of red. I know the red symbolizes something. I know the fire symbolizes something. The house symbolizes something. And I know Tandy about to go in on it.
Yes.
Yes, she is. I'm glad that there's those concepts. And I like that you mentioned the member that is cat-like, because he did a very cat-like mannerism by pushing the glass of the filled glass off the table. I was like, and then it was a filled glass, so I felt like that means something as well. And then like to purposely put fruits in a blender and not put the blender on top and make it go everywhere, like that was obviously purposeful. So I find a lot of the concepts interesting, but I know I would have to hear from somebody that knows more or knows better or likes to dive into themes to let me know. But I think as far as how it was done production-wise, I think it is good enough for somebody that doesn't know to watch and be like, okay, you know, maybe they'll get more interested in it. Maybe not. They'll be like, yo, who dying? Like, why he killing somebody? Mm-hmm. You know, it's going to be stuff like that that maybe would bring somebody in or not. You know, who knows? So, yeah, I would like to hear what Tandy has to say.
This is a teenage movie gone wrong. No, I'm just kidding.
I mean, it could be.
Like, no, honestly, let me take you back. No, I'm just kidding. I do have a lot. It has nothing to do with TXT theories. I don't. Okay. I have unsubscribed from Big Hit Theories a very long time ago.
I will never unsubscribe.
Everything that I think is specific to the video and not to the chain of videos.
Okay.
Let's start with colors, shall we?
Yeah.
So, you guys noticed that the outfits, the tan outfits, right?
Mm-hmm.
And they switched to black. So, low-key, back in the day, in middle school, tan was my favorite color. Tan represents warmth, security, stability, duty, and responsibility, right? So wearing that color all together and them dancing together at the beginning made me think that they feel like they still had like a duty to each other, a responsibility to their relationship, and it's hard to break that.
And
when
the house wasn't burning when they were in that color.
Right, and the house is also tan. Like, it's just like a, you know, a house is security. It's warmth. So many things with that. Okay, so there's that. But when they switch to black, which also means a lot of things, but if we're going to do a little bit more negative or a little bit more different than saying like it's powerful, it's like very positive connotations, this is more neutral and negative, it's also seriousness, fear, mystery, aggression, despair, and overwhelming, because black is an overwhelming color.
Yes.
So I'm thinking that their emotions, the way they feel, is engulfing them. Like, usually people are like, I'm wearing black because it makes me feel powerful, but it also can make you feel an emotion even more. You can feel sad and you want to wear black. You don't wear white when you're sad. You just be like, now I'm going to put on the blackest thing in my closet, because it engulfs you and it absorbs, because black absorbs light, right? The darkness absorbs light. Mm-hmm. So that blackness is taking all of their emotions and like exacerbating them, right? Okay. So red can represent destruction, blood, guilt, anger, and war.
Ooh.
So they're at war with themselves. The food represents the I know Marie had like a different interpretation of why it was red food, but for me, I think it represented two things: their insecurities and actual like fire from war. Like they're at war with themselves, but they're outwardly firing. So you, when you outwardly fire, you misfire, you run the risk of hitting everybody else around you. Mm-hmm. And so I felt like they kept saying like, who's a liar? But I think they're all liars because they're lying to themselves. Mm-hmm. They're going out of who they were, and they keep saying, who's a liar, who's a liar? Yeah, you could say the cat was a liar or whatever, but I feel like it's all of them not being real about, like, they've been forever changed. So if you're forever changed and you can't express your feelings to your friends, then it creates a toxic relationship. And there goes the food again, showing that their toxicity that they're throwing out at each other is actually just what they feel within. It's not that they're trying to be toxic to their friends. It's just like they've changed so much that their friendship no longer means what it did. Okay. But because they're together trying to fake like, oh, they're having a good time, it's because they don't want to get rid of their friendship. It means so much to them. Mm-hmm. There's a reason why they became friends, right? But you got to understand, when you grow or when something happens to you, good or bad, you start to manifest into a different person. And if your friends no longer understand, they automatically start to become toxic. So no matter what you say, it's just you're going to be in a pool of lies because you can't explain to them, this is who I am now, and they may not accept who you are now, right? So what else did I write? At the beginning, I mean, before I went all, you know, through all this, I was like, is he trying to kill him? Oh my God. The baby's dead, you know? Fire represents the rebirth for me. They're burning down the house, which is tan, right? And earlier I said that was a sense of warmth and security, stability. They're burning that down. Now it's chaos. And that's when they come out in the black, right? Because it wasn't on fire when they were wearing the tan. It was on fire when they were wearing the black, right?
Yes.
Right. Okay. Okay. Yeah. So tan felt like, it, before I researched the colors, tan outfits meant to me innocence and black meant evolution. So the presence of change.
Okay.
Red was intensity. The more red you see, the more intense everything got. The question I asked myself, what do you do when your friends don't understand you anymore? So I feel like that's the theme, without knowing whatever else they're going through in all their theory videos, is what do you do when you grow out of your relationships? And most people can't tell you what to do.
Okay, when you're, I have something.
Okay.
No, you go ahead. Yeah, when you're done.
So I took it as self. I took self further. Struggling with the new me, not knowing how to feel when I change and how to express that change. They promise to be together forever, but the lies will continue as long as they don't change. They don't show them real, their real self. And also, it's a lie in general, their whole relationship, because the foreverness of friendship that it, you know, friendship symbolizes is a lie, because you don't always keep every friend, right? So I feel like everyone's a liar in that sense. Like, I can't keep my promise, even though I promised this to you. And then, so many layers. This is the last thing I'm going to say, because I have so much written down, but like, I'm going to just, this is the last thing I'm going to say, okay, about the symbolism. I think that they're taking the element of growth and showing it in a negative light. Because most people, when they talk about, oh, I'm growing up, they do, oh, I'm growing up, I'm going to the party, I'm doing this, I'm doing that, my friends are still the same. But they're showing that, like, it also can be negative. Your friends can also be toxic when you grow, or you could be toxic to your friends when you grow. So them throwing it back at each other and, like, essentially killing your friends, because you're killing your friendship by not being honest with yourself. Because that's more, that's first before you're honest with your friends. If you're not honest with yourself, then how are you going to tell the truth to your friend? Okay. So, production-wise, fantastic. The song, really like the song. I was with Sam. I can't watch this and listen to the song again. Like, I want them separate, because the video is so much going on that you want to like look at the video and not really take in like their vocals. Right. And I played the song again and I looked down and just wrote notes instead of, you know, paying attention to that, because I really wanted to be like, okay, do I like this song? Mm-hmm. Yes, I do. I love their vocals. They're very mm-hmm. crisp. And then the yes. mastering of the track, like at the beginning when it came in, I was like, yo, this is crazy. My earphones were, I just was like, I have cheap earphones in right now. And it sounded so high quality. I was like, yo, this is going to be lit. And then I got sucked into the music video. So yeah. it kind of sucks because I'm like, dang, I want to pay attention to what you're singing to me. But your music video is saying a lot, even though it's mm-hmm. like, it's not too much going on, you know. Yeah. But it's just so much story that you're like, oh, that's right. Can you see? Okay, house is on fire.
Yeah.
You know, it doesn't go together in a way. Mm-hmm. You ever listen to a song where it's like the beat and the melody is lit, but when you watch the video, you're like, I'm not sure if like this was the video I would have put with it.
Absolutely.
Because the song has a lot of intricacies.
I feel like you'll like the dance performance video when they do it, because it won't be as intricate. This is definitely very story oriented to go with their I hate bringing up the Big Brother, but the way that they did BTS, they did a story in each music video added on to the next. That's what they're doing with TXT. Each music video is
really.
That's what I said. This one is story based, where it's adding on to whatever the next video is going to be something that encompasses what this one was, and then go from there.
I'm not saying that like BTS, I'm familiar that all of theirs was a story, right? But I don't always feel overwhelmed. This felt overwhelming because there was a lot I needed to see in the music video to like get the story in the music video, and there was a lot in the song. And I'm like hearing that I love the song, but I'm like staring at the music video like, oh shit, okay, so the house is on fire. Well, who set the house on fire? You know, nothing makes wrong sense with either or. It's just together.
It was a lot.
If you're a person like me and Sam that don't follow TXT, like we listen to their songs, like Cat Dog was like probably the last one we listened to. No, I lied. We listened to another one. But that was the one we really liked.
Yeah.
And it was just, you know, it went together, right? And then this, I forgot which one we watched, and it was like a story. Mm-hmm. And the story, that story didn't feel overwhelming. I think
it was, Runaway. It was the one before this. We watched Runaway together.
No, it wasn't that one.
Yeah, Runaway. Runaway was in a school.
No. It wasn't a school. Yeah, mm-hmm. they were like in a forest, and there was a moon, and then there was a, it was a lot. It was, I don't know. It was after
That's
Cat
what
Dog.
She was watching, though. I thought you was talking about one that looked like Cat Dog, but wasn't quite Cat Dog.
No, that was like their debut. No, room. I wasn't talking about that one. There was a story one that came out, and
Nap of a Star.
Yes, that one. When, that was
yeah,
a
with
story.
The deer, the mm-hmm. antlers yeah. and stuff. Okay.
Yes. That, I didn't feel like the song or the video took away from each other.
Mm-hmm.
And this is such a movie that it's taking away from the song, which is the soundtrack, right? You know what I'm saying? It's mm-hmm. such a movie that I'm, like, into the movie. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, turn down the song. I'm trying to figure out what's going on here.
Yeah. Makes sense.
Right?
So I feel like if I didn't, now I'm going to go in the perspective of reading the lyrics as opposed to watching it without the subtitles, right? So I feel like if I watch it with the subtitles and I wasn't familiar with them, I would relate the whole growing out of your friends or like having this inner turmoil of mm-hmm. with growth and mm-hmm. becoming an adult. I would think it's that kind of thing, like teenage inner turmoil. Like,
yeah.
Like growing, mm-hmm. what do I do with myself? But then I will also kind of relate it, the whole island and people being somewhere else kind of thing and not growing or growing and or not even being sure if they're growing, mm-hmm. I would relate that to Peter Pan. So in some aspect of it, I thought about Peter Pan because I was like, all right, what island or what place are they talking about? Why are they talking about being grown and not grown or grown and growing out of something, you know, that kind of thing. So
yeah, that's
in
cool.
a way,
yeah.
that's where my mind went only because, like I said, if I don't know the story and I'm reading the subs, mm-hmm. I would be like, okay, there's something going on here having to do with not understanding what's going on. And I don't know.
Well, honestly,
I don't know why Peter Pan was what popped into my head.
If you think a Nap of a Star and you add even all of these ones on their island, it kind of mm-hmm. does fit with the Peter Pan thought process because
right.
they're the lost boys trying to find their way. So exactly. You never know. We'll
That's
see.
That's exactly what I was thinking. Padass.
Okay, so with that, you guys, what would you give this out of
strawberries?
Strawberries.
I'm sorry, they really made me want strawberries.
That works.
That was quick.
What would you give this out of strawberries?
Marie, go first.
Yeah, I was like,
for me personally, again, I have a non-biased bias, but because I like the universe and theories, and after watching multiple times, I really liked it, I would give it a 9.5. That non 0.5 is for the confusion for people who might not know TXT, and that video would not be as straightforward and wouldn't be understandable. Because even for me, I was like, I get it. Which I think my first thought process without knowing anything about this video and watching it was still pretty true to what I had thought at the end. So that's why I'm like, it made sense to me. But for other people, I can completely understand how this is a lot going on. I don't know what's going on. So I will say 9.5. But I really enjoy that this is a song that's going to go on my playlist because I like the beat, I like their voices, everything about this. I'm really excited to listen to their album.
You know what's funny? This is not a song you would show someone who's just getting into K-pop.
Yes.
Do not do that.
That would confuse the heck out of
you them. Can show them the song itself, like on Spotify, but the music video, no. They'd be like, yo, I can't get into this. What's going
that's
on?
Too, that's too much. You got to explain. Go step by step.
This would make them not want to do K-pop. Yeah. I don't
want to
do K-pop. No.
Yeah.
All right, Sam?
I wanted Tandy to go next.
Oh, Tandy?
Unless you want me to go next.
I don't care. One of y'all got to go.
For me, I have two different scores. I give the video by itself a 10. The song by itself a 10. But putting it together as like one package, it feels like an 8.5. Because the distraction of the video distracts me from the song. But when I focus on the song, I don't get what's in the video. If I'm not looking at the video, like if I'm not paying attention, you get what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It takes away from one or the other. If as separate things, they're tens.
Wait, but when you we could do that? I could do that because I'm going to do what she did, except my stays a 9.5, but it's a 10 and a 10. I realize you could do that because that's literally what my 9.5 was taken away from.
Oh, wow.
So.
Oh, okay. No, I mean, because we said, I mean, if you read our description, we talk about what all these things are that make up our scores. And I kind of want to explain before I give my overall, because like we have different categories. The concept, I feel, is the 10. Vocals, a 10. Lyrical composition, 10. It factor, 10. Wow factor, 10. But as a pack, overall package, because you got to put it together at the end, it's like an 8.5 because they're too distracting for each other. I want to listen to the song because it's so good. But then if I look away and just like zone out for a second for the song, then I miss so much in the music video. And the point is to also look at the music video in conjunction. So as a person who isn't into TXT as much as I should be, right, as one would tell me to be, it is a 8.5.
Understandable. Okay. I appreciate that score. I like the breakdown. Okay, Sam, your turn now.
Okay. I am going to give it a 7.5, mainly because, like I said, I'm not going to do a breakdown of the score, but or like say this was this and this was that. Because for me, I am doing it as an overall package, and that's why I give it a 7.5. It does look good. I would listen to the song altogether. Yeah, I'm sticking with that because it is a little too confusing for somebody that's on the outside, and I feel like that will off-put someone. So that's the only reason why I would do that. But, like I said, for the people of the universe or for people of the fandom, I totally can see why they would be like, no, I love this, you know, because it goes deeper and you got to go back to all the 15.
Yeah, Sam's right. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I love maybe two videos, but normally a self-contained concept. Because if you really love a group, but like, say, for instance, you're not in the K-pop at the moment, like you're so busy that you haven't been able to keep up with a lot of things. And it's understandable. You know, you don't have time to always keep up. Then you come back and you watch something, you're like, what did I miss? What is the break in the chain? Then you got to go back and watch everything. But the point is to love what is presented in itself.
Right.
Yeah, that's first. Then all this other extra stuff is second.
It come after, right? Exactly. Mm-hmm. And then you have the choice to decide if you do want to
exactly
get into it. You know,
it could turn you off so much. Like, yeah, I'm gonna listen to this song on Spotify, absolutely, but I can't.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But I stick to my 8.5. The voice sound amazing, and the video is well shot. Mm-hmm. Oh, also, I did deduct points for styling.
You gotta speak on the style because that was one of the first things you mentioned to us.
Okay, shorts
on Kai
should not be.
Oh, and Boomy.
Yeah, two of them.
Shorts, just I don't understand the concept of doing such hard choreography in shorts. It takes away from the element of like intensity. Could you like. Why you got shorts on, bro? You need some pants. Like, come on. I don't know. It's just something about also the sweater. I think the tan outfits in general, like, bother me the most. Mm-hmm. I don't think the way that the person styled it looks very, I don't want to say comfortable, but it doesn't look, it just doesn't look good. Like, that striped sweater that one of them had on with the cutouts in the show. I'm like, I don't know.
Like, it was designed to look more schoolboyish or to look more, like,
that's kiddish. Not my issue.
And maybe, No, I get it. I get, because I don't know. I'm just guessing. Maybe that's part of what the theory was with that particular choice of outfits. Just because, you know, in the black is more mature, a more mature look, and in the tan, it was supposed to be more like young, still going to school. Because
what they wore in the house would have been fine to dance in.
Oh, they still have shorts on in the black too.
Yeah, they do. But I do like the black outfit.
But I just don't know them as much. The shorts and the black don't bother me.
Yes, they don't. Yeah. But the socks are higher, and they have on black socks that are like almost knee high. So
it's still weird.
Maybe that was their inside the house outfit.
Still a weird choice.
We're talking about shorts.
Okay. All right. So, Tandy, where can they find us?
They can find us everywhere at KONNECTDENT. If you put a .com on that, then you can go to our bottom bar on our website and find everything, including Join Community, which is our Discord channel. And everyone who loves music and K-pop can join us and talk about, I don't know, everything. Sometimes we have questions of the day, posts of the day. It could be about food. It could be about learning the language. And it could be about just something you saw in news and gossip. Because we, you know, we be talking.
Talk about everything.
We got to talk about everything. Well, that's not it. We also have concert series that we do. We're on season 3. And I believe this week is Taemin and GOT7.
Yes.
Yeah. And I'm super excited because the GOT7 concert we're going to be looking at is the concert that me and Marie went to together. And went to our first concert together, and it was so amazing. But join us on Twitch for that. Of course, it is at Konnect'd ENT or Twitch/Konnect'd ENT, as well as we have our connection blog, which will be adding new blogs very, very soon. And if you want to submit to that, just do blog@konnect'dent.com and write in the subject, "This is my blog." Put everything in there, and we will email you back about it and possibly posted for you for our community tab on the connection blog. Yes. Wait, there's more. Konnect'd does so much.
Wow, we got lost up with them.
The connection. What's next? Podcast. We do a podcast, and we're going to have a new podcast coming up soon. But the latest one you can find is Mostly Fandom, Are You Really? That's a deep subject.
It is.
It was conversation. It was long. It was vast. So thank you guys so much for joining us on this React and Discuss of TXT. And we will see you next time somewhere, someplace.
Konnect'd? Yes. Konnect'd? Over and out. I'm lost, you're mine.